My name is Paris Vigil, and this is my microbiology soil research. So in a capsule, or in summary, this is... Can I start over? This is my first time presenting? Hi, my name is Paris Vigil, and this is my microbiology soil research. So in a nutshell, in today's world, there's a very underrated problem. Antibiotic resistance. A lot of people are resistant to different kinds of antibiotics, and it's really expensive to kind of produce these antibiotics in pharmaceutical companies. So that's why they use people like us to try and find antibiotics within things like soil. So first of all, we started with cereal dilutions, and we took a gram of soil and 9 milliliters of water, and we mixed it in the test tube. And then through different series, we took less and less soil and water. So basically just diluting the soil and water combination. And then after we did the cereal dilutions, we moved it to a master plate. And I guess I should talk about where I got my soil, first of all. So I originally collected my soil from a residential backyard area in Lawrence, Kansas, but my soil did not produce any antibiotic properties, so I adopted my bacteria from Anna Kawasi. And so from there, I was able to follow through with my experiment. And so after I obtained her bacteria from a master plate, I grew it on the master plate, and then I was able to take it and perform various testings. The first one would be Gram staining, and this is just taking the bacteria and staining it with crystal violet. And if done correctly, Gram positive is purple and Gram negative is pink. And mine was Gram variable, and this means it was Gram positive and Gram negative. Can't see it, but if you look closely, there's purple and pink within the organisms you can see under the microscope. And then afterwards, we did an endospore staining, and this is done with malachite green. And if done correctly, spores will form, and those spores will turn green. And after that, we went ahead and did a Kirby-Bauer sensitivity test, and this was to tell whether or not a bacteria, or our bacteria, was susceptible to different kinds of antibiotics. And mine ended up being susceptible to vancomycin and ciprofloxacin, and my measurements came out to be the zones of inhibition measured to be about 24 millimeters for vancomycin and 35 millimeters for ciprofloxacin, and there was no zone of inhibition for the trimethoprim. And then we went ahead and did various biochemical tests, and so the first one, we did a catalase test, and this was just taking our bacteria and mixing it with hydrogen peroxide, and if it bubbled, that means it tested positive. And so mine tested positive, and our biochemical test followed a flowchart. Wait, I don't have the flowchart pictured, but the flowchart is the PPID flowchart, I think that's what it's called, the Bacillus SPPID flowchart, excuse me. And so after I did the catalase test, I went ahead and did a starch hydrolysis test, and this is just taking my bacteria and growing it on a plate and then covering it with iodine. And if you can see here, a little red ring forms, and this indicates that it tests positive. And then afterwards, we went ahead and did a VP test, and it tested negative, and we did a citrate test, and it tested negative as well. And this concluded that... Once I was following the flowchart, I came up with the conclusion that my bacteria, hopefully I don't butcher this name, was Bacillus baetius. And to further my research, I would perform more PCR tests. We did the PCR tests in the lab, but we were unable to find the specific sequence that we wanted due to not having a specific primer made for our bacteria. We use more of a universal primer. And so I would like to further my research by getting a specific primer specifically for my bacteria. And I would also like to collect my own soil sample from the area that Anna got the soil, so I'm able to test or do the experiment from beginning to end. So that is my research in a nutshell.